Hello, I'm Tristan. It may surprise you to learn the power bills have been a tinsy-wincy little bit high recently.
All right, here we go. 75, that's 75, 75, that'll be now 100. There now, 125, 125, 125 there.
Yeah. Okay, so due to soaring energy bills, I decided to see exactly how much electric my smart home uses. To do this, I tested out a few different energy monitors and ended up using my Casa smart plug, which has built-in energy monitoring. It's surprisingly accurate, and it goes down to just half a watt, meaning that even quite low power devices can be tested. Okay, so let's take a look at the results, and spoiler alert, I was genuinely surprised at Philips Hue's power use. But before looking at those, I wanted to quickly cover my four Amazon products first. So the first item I tested was the Amazon Echo Flex, and it always uses a similar amount of energy, which is around 2 to 3 watts. Whether you're playing music or it's in standby mode, it doesn't vary by all that much, maybe by half a watt, so this is a fairly energy efficient device. Next up is the Amazon Echo Show. This is an 8-inch model, the second gen, and it uses around 6 to 8 watts after starting up. I also wanted to test putting the screen off. This device has a lot of features to turn the screen off at night. This does then go down to 4 to 5.5 watts. So it does save some energy if the screen is off, which is good to know. Then if the screen is back on, if you play music or you watch a YouTube video, it goes to around 7 watts, which is still fairly energy efficient. I was half expecting this device to use a lot more energy, to be honest. The maximum power use I could get out of the Echo Show was when I did a drop-in mode, and this then used up to 9 watts. Which again isn't really all that high. I also tested my full-size Echo second gen, which uses between 2 and 4 watts of electricity. Finally, I tested the Amazon smart plug. When this device is in standby by clicking the side button, what you notice is that it uses close to 1 watt of electricity, which is quite a lot considering it's not actually doing anything. It's in standby mode. And if you then turn it on so it can actually supply a device power, it uses up to 1.5 watts. Which seems quite high for a device which doesn't actually do anything. It can't play music or anything like that. So that's it for the Amazon devices. They are fairly energy efficient. I was pleasantly surprised at the Echo Show, although the Amazon smart plug did use slightly more energy than I thought it would have, especially compared to the Philips Hue equivalent. So next up, I tested the Hue smart plug, and this is more energy efficient. It actually uses less than half a watt when it's in standby mode. I then put it on, and it uses just over half a watt, which is pretty good. It might be because this is Zigbee, which is slightly more energy efficient than Wi-Fi, which the Amazon smart plug uses. It's worth bearing this in mind if you want to have a lot of smart plugs around your home. Next, you've got the Philips Hue bridge. I tested a few different things, including playing lab formulas, and it didn't really go over 2 watts. So this is quite an efficient Zigbee-based hub, which is great to know because I've got quite a lot of Hue devices and accessories hooked up to this and is still not using much energy. Next, I've got a dimmed down Philips Hue white ambient candle bulb, and it uses around 2 watts even though it's at 70% brightness, which is good. If you then put it to 100% brightness, it used slightly more, but only around 4 watts total, which is still fairly energy efficient. Next up, we have the Philips Hue indoor light strip, which when it's in color mode, only uses around 2 watts. If I then put this up to 100% brightness at green, it then uses slightly more, around 7 to 8 watts at peak. But what you will notice with any of the RGB color devices from Philips Hue is if you then put it to white, that's what uses the most energy. So you're looking at around 20 watts now, which is a decent amount. That's a fair amount of electric. Next up, we have the 5-meter Hue outdoor light strip, and in color mode, it uses around 16 to 20 watts of electric at full brightness. But then if we go over to white, as you can probably guess by now, it's going to use more electric. It actually uses 40 watts, which is quite a lot. I know that it's a 5-meter light strip, and it pumps out a fair amount of light, but 40 watts still seems like quite a lot to me, for what is still just an LED light strip. Then if you change back to color again, as soon as it's green, it will use slightly less power, 20 to 22 watts. The good news here, though, is that at just 10% brightness, dimming it down, you're looking at less than 3 watts. And that's quite good to know because, yes, I know it's not pumping out much light now, but at nighttime, it actually looks quite good for ambient lighting, and 2 watts is pretty good, I think. Next, we have a Hue PC gradient strip, which at full brightness and white uses around 15 watts of electricity. but obviously a lot of the time this will actually mirror the same color as what's on your screen. So we go for blue to test that, and it then uses less at around 4 to 5 watts, which is quite energy efficient actually. When you dim it down, for example, to white at 35% brightness, it then uses less than 2 watts, which is great. Overall, I was a bit surprised by my Hue devices. While some are low power, the light strips used more than I would have expected. Although the fact that the outdoor light strip clearly says 40 watts should have been a hint to me. But as long as you don't keep these light strips on 24/7, they shouldn't cost too much to run. I also wanted to quickly test my Google Nest Mini, which is the only Google device I actually have. And this uses around 2 watts, which is actually similar to the Amazon Echo Flex. I played music and used different features on it, and it never really went above 2 watts. So this is an energy efficient device too. Now on to testing Ring devices. I'll start off with the Ring Chime, and this uses up to half a watt. My monitoring device can't actually track below this half a watt level, as you can see, but in general it uses up to half a watt even when playing a chime sound, which is good to know. Next up we have the Ring Alarm base station, which uses Z-Wave and is quite low power. It never uses more than 3 watts. The second gen model contains a built-in router, which uses then slightly more energy, but neither are massive energy users. Now we've got the Ring Indoor Cam, which uses between 1 and 2 watts, whether it's recording or in standby mode. Sorry about the dodgy makeshift bass. Oh, I'm so cool. Sorry, I'm just smacking this over. But overall, this doesn't use much more than 2 watts. While I only tested 3 Ring devices there, you can see that they're all fairly low power. I was always curious about how much energy a smart camera would use, and so I was pleasantly surprised that it used less than a TV in standby mode at 1 or 2 watts. Next up, we have a Tapo indoor camera, and this is similar to Ring's indoor camera. It's fairly energy efficient and uses between 1 and 2 watts of energy. I tested a few different scenarios and it never went over 2 watts. The Blink Mini Indoor Cam is actually the most energy efficient of them all. It never went over 1.2 watts and it's actually frequently below 1 watt even when recording, which is quite good. I know it's not the most powerful of smart cameras, but it's still quite good to know just how energy efficient this is. Finally, we have got the SwitchBot Pan and Tilt, which when you first turn it on, in standby mode, it uses around 4 watts, which is a decent amount. It's turning around. But then when it actually fully starts up, like now, it goes down to around 2 to 3 watts. So it uses slightly more power than some of the other cameras, but not really by that much. Right, I've worked out. If you own an electric shower and you skip showering for a month, then you can run your entire smart home for a whole decade. Nice. Oh, God. But seriously, whilst electric showers are really expensive, I was pleasantly surprised that many smart home devices used less power than I actually thought they would have. The UK currently has a price cap, was that dramatic enough? A price cap that's totally not a price cap, of 34 pence per kilowatt hour. This means that I am paying 10 pence a day, or £3 a month, for my 2 Echo shows. And if I went nuts and I had 10 Google Nest Minis and 5 smart devices around my home, this would cost me around 30 pence a day. And whilst £9 a month isn't exactly cheap, if you needed so many devices, then it's probably worth that, in my opinion. But I was a bit surprised to see how much electric my Philips Hue light strips used. Whilst the usage does drop down a lot with RGB colours and also when dimming, using 20 to 40 watts at full white brightness surprised me. If I ran my light strips for 24 hours a day, I'd be looking at £5 a month for my Hue indoor light strip and £10 a month for the outdoor Hue light strip. That seems quite high to me for a single product. Thankfully though, you could combine this with a Hue motion sensor and have the light strips go off automatically after a minute or two if no one is around. You can also set up schedules in the app to turn the strips off at a set time. This is what I do with all of my Hue light strips, and it means that the total cost is less than £1 a month. That just about wraps up today's video. I hope you enjoyed it and found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to this channel and click the bell icon, which will notify you when I release a new video. Thank you.